What's up? You're all sick and tired of sitting around waiting for me, huh? Well, I'm sorry. You know we had some problems before. Well, hello everyone. It's week 5 of the course, and this week we're looking at crime and punishment. Now, what Robo and his friends have been carrying on about is we started to make this clip, and I got a message up on the screen saying you're running out of disk space, so I had to stop the clip, save it, and then restart it, transfer files across to other areas of the computer. Yes, so you had to wait. Okay, that's not... Patience is a virtue. You should just wait. Anyway, what's that, Robert? There's lots of other clips from previous years up on the course webpage as well. Yes, where we look at things, the same topics, and that's right, we actually talk about the same things each year. Well, I guess that's reassuring in one way, because it indicates the law doesn't change. Now, Pencil Dog, can you move away from here? You go over and stand over there near Angel Learning. Oh, red on red. Oh, that's why you want to stand here on the black. Okay. Look, about this crime and punishment stuff, a few key ideas. First one is, the law says what a crime is, and what has been regarded as criminal conduct at one stage may not necessarily be so at a later time, because community attitudes change. The other thing is, like 100 years ago, I don't think we had the computers, we weren't making little clips like this, so as technology changes, they need to introduce laws to regulate the use of the technology and the appropriate use of the technology. With a crime, yes, that's right, the standard of proof is beyond reasonable doubt. That's because there is a punishment generally associated with it, and because they're more severe and may affect the liberty of a person, we need to be pretty sure we've got it right. Angel Learning, if someone's found not guilty, does that mean they're innocent? Well, that's not necessarily the case, because sometimes a person can be found not guilty, and that means that the prosecution wasn't able to prove the case beyond a reasonable doubt, and that's so they're found not guilty, they're not convicted. Whether or not they actually did the or committed the crime is still an open point in some cases. Yes, and types of punishment. Yeah, well, types of penalties have changed over time. In fact, if you look at any legal history, you'll find some of the penalties which were imposed in earlier times are really quite barbaric by today's standards. These days, the penalties which can be imposed are regulated by legislation, and there's mechanisms to ensure that the offenders, when they're subject to punishment, are treated fairly. Yes, and we've also got greater awareness now for victims of crime. They're the people who've been affected by the criminal behaviour. And they have compensation schemes in place. Oh dear, I've got this tickle in my throat. Maybe if I grab a swig of coffee or something, that'll improve it, okay? But victims of crime, very important, new evolving area in the law. I think they're the main points. But I think the point about go and look at the earlier videos, they're very useful. They've got a lot of information. Yes, okay, so... Yes, I'm sorry you had to stay and wait and we had to do it again, but I think it's turned out okay. I hope so. Look, my Pencil Dog's over here. Pencil Dog wants to be on the black computer Matt, because it shows up. Yes. Okay, so you haven't got another character hiding around there. I wonder if anyone can see that other character yet. And Central Queensland University, yes, we can all be what we want to be at Central Queensland University. Yes, it's a great place, isn't it? It is a really wonderful university. And yes, lots of very clever people who work in here. Yeah. What do you like being here, Pencil Dog? That's good. I'm pleased. I'm sure I'd like everyone to like being here. Well, you just say goodbye for this week. Okay? Bye-bye. Goodbye, Robolawyer. I'm going to turn this off now. It's been a funny old day.